Greetings. Brother, I hear over and over a question from those in Islam, and it comes in various forms, so I'll show them to you. I'm sure you've heard them. If Jesus was God, how could men kill him? How could men overpower him if Jesus was God? Shouldn't Jesus as God be stronger than them? And the question comes in other forms as well, refined and changed, expressing the exasperation and confusion of ignorance. And I understand, brother, that if your thinking is formed by Muhammad's religion, such questioning seems impossible to answer. But, brother, they all reveal just how little Islam allows you to hear and know and understand about what Jesus really said and taught. And equally importantly, brother, just how little you and Islam know about the message of the prophets. Here is the short answer. It was God's plan from before creation to redeem man from sin that God knew mankind would commit. I'm sure that does not make sense to you, because this act of love is nothing the Allah of Islam could be imagined doing. But let's take a look at what the Word of God says, brother. 1 Corinthians 2:7. But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery. You believe that God is greater than us, right, my friend? Do you also honestly accept that God's wisdom is above our natural reasoning ability? But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory. Do you think God can really have such a plan, brother? The Bible teaches that God knows the end from before the beginning. I think that is reasonable for a God who knows everything. 1 Corinthians 2:8, which none of the princes of this world knew. You may think this is earthly princes, right? But this is speaking of spiritual princes and powers in the spirit realm. For had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. Before moving on, let's just affirm that the princes are spiritual and not just earthly princes. Ephesians 2, verse 1 and 2, and you were dead in your trespasses and sins, in which you formerly walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, of the spirit that is now working in the sons of disobedience. Here, the spirit that works in the sons of disobedience is called the prince of the power of the air. John 14:30. Hereafter, I will not talk much with you, for the prince of this world comes and has nothing in me. Again, Jesus speaks of the prince of this world, but not an earthly prince. I want you to clearly think about this, brother. God knows everything. Does your religion teach you to think this or not? If God knows everything, including the future, God knew that man would sin. But let's get back to the question. If Jesus was God, how could men kill God? And the short answer was, it was according to God's will and God's plan. Now, this answer probably does not satisfy you for the moment, and I understand why that would be the case. So I will gladly explain if you will just hang in there and listen. First, let me establish it was God's plan. We know this because Jesus, the Lamb of God, was considered slain even before creation. Revelation 13:8. All inhabitants of the earth will worship the beast, all whose names have not been written in the Lamb's Book of Life, the Lamb who was slain from the creation of the world. And second, was it God's will for Jesus to die on the cross? We know it was, because on the night before, Jesus prayed this, Luke 22:42, "And he," this being Jesus, "said, Father, if you are willing, let this cup pass from me. However, not my will, but yours be done." Jesus prayed that God's will would be done on the cross. And what could possibly motivate God to do such a thing? John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but shall have eternal life." God was and always will be motivated by love, brother, because God is love. 2 Peter 3:9, "The Lord is not slow to fulfill his promise, as some count slowness, but is patient toward you, not wishing that any should perish, but that all should reach repentance." God is patiently waiting for you to accept his gift. God is waiting for all who will accept his gift. And God knows exactly who that is, brother. But let me be clear. God did not predestine exactly who would be saved. He predestined the mechanism that we would be conformed to the image of his Son. Romans 8:29, "For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren." So God knew from before the creation that we would sin against him. And still, he created us and offered us his plan of salvation. But obviously, God decided that without shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness for sins. Hebrews 9:22, "And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without shedding of blood is no remission." There is a theme throughout the Old Testament about the value of blood. Genesis 4:10, "The Lord said, What have you done? Listen, your brother's blood cries out to me from the ground." Proverbs 6:16-9, "There are six things the Lord hates, seven that are detestable to him: haughty eyes, a lying tongue. Number three in the list is hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked schemes, feet that are quick to rush into evil, and a false witness who pours out lies, a man who stirs up dissension among brothers." And God's command tells you why for the value of blood. Leviticus 17:11, "For the life of a creature is in the blood, and I have given it to you to make atonement for yourselves on the altar. It is the blood that makes atonement for one's life." You see, brother, this fact is completely missing from Muhammad's religion. But notice the second part of God's message. "And I have given it to you to make atonement for yourselves on the altar." This even ascribes the reason for the very existence of blood. It is the blood that makes atonement for one's life. Read it again. "It is the blood that makes atonement for one's life." And remember, this is Prophet Moses in the Torah. Leviticus 17:14, "For the life of every creature is its blood. Its blood is its life. Therefore I have said to the people of Israel, you shall not eat the blood of any creature, for the life of every creature is its blood. Whoever eats it shall be cut off." And what does this have to do with Jesus being God and being killed by men? Brother, God was to redeem mankind. And God has stated the only way for atonement is shedding blood. For God to redeem mankind, blood must be shed. His blood. Only his blood pure and sinless, could satisfy the cost of atonement. Only God had pure and holy blood by which all humanity could be redeemed and atoned. Only God, brother. Hebrews 10:4, for it is impossible for the blood of bulls and goats to take away sins. Consequently, when Christ came into the world, he said, sacrifices and offerings you, God, have not desired, but a body you have prepared for me. In burnt offerings and sin offerings you have taken no pleasure. Then I said, behold, I have come to do your will, O God, as it is written of me in the scroll of the book. This is about Jesus, brother, saying the scriptures wrote about him. This is Jesus confirming that he came to do God's will, and he means his death on the cross. So, brother, this sacrifice to shed blood to atone for all mankind required Jesus to die on the cross. If you honestly look at this reality, based on the message of God, the crucifixion becomes an obvious fulfillment. And the men who participated in the crucifixion were acting according to God's plan, not thwarting or derailing it. And if Jesus had not willingly gone to the cross, there was no force on earth that could have made him. Matthew 26:52, then Jesus told him, put your sword back in its place, because all who take up a sword will perish by a sword. Or do you think, I cannot call on my Father, and he will provide me at once with more than 12 legions of angels? But how then should the scriptures be fulfilled that it must be so? How then should the scriptures be fulfilled? Think about that for a moment, brother. But how then should the scriptures be fulfilled? You see, brother, Jesus knew the will of God and knew that his death on the cross fulfilled the scriptures, the message of God by the prophets. So his death on the cross was not the result of men surprising God or overpowering God. Quite the contrary, God surprised the princes of this world with a plan they could never have guessed. 1 Corinthians 2:8, which none of the princes of this world knew, for had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. And there you have it, brother. No man could overpower God. But God could and did lay down his life as Jesus, as a sacrifice. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.